Hi Libra, I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. For those of you who are seeking deeper clarity, be it in your love lives or your career, for a personal consultation, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Librans, we begin the month with your ruling planet Venus, and she's retrograde till about 16th, and she's retrograde in a part of your chart that is all about partnerships, and it is about your marriage. And she's joined by Sun and Uranus over here. Now, she's retrograde in this part of your house for a couple of days before she moves on into your house of work and health. But we're beginning the month with the energy being quite introspective as far as your relationships are concerned. And Librans, there's nothing more in life for you than your relationships are. And so a lot of introspection on your relationships, on what can be better, what can be worked upon, things that maybe you're being asked to change, and how open is it to you to change. There could be self-realization as well, that you know certain things really need to go out of your life, or really in the way specifically where you are in a relationship, the person that you are in a relationship. On the towards the end of the week, we have Venus, and she moves into your house of work and health, and she is joined by Neptune over there. So you could be reconnecting with your dreams on, you know, maybe your dream work, maybe your dream project, maybe something that you wanted to work on for the longest, and you could start reconnecting with that. For some of you, it could be reconnecting with your dream of, you know, your maybe your health regime, maybe your gym, maybe your workout, and how it is that you have maybe for the longest wanted to, you know, take care of yourself, or maybe get into an exercise regime or a diet, and you could be focusing. On the 10th, we have Mercury, which is retrograde till about 5th of May, and this is happening in your house of joint finances, resources, sexuality and intimacy, and we also have Mars over here. And later this moves on to your house of marriage. So a lot of focus this month is there on two most important things that you breathe on, Librans. One is your marriage, your partnerships, and the second is power struggles between people whom you love, and intimacy as well. Now, with this entire retrograde, like all Mercury retrogrades, communications are going to be hard. You can expect being misunderstood, and travel plans going awry, or even negotiations falling. Avoid buying any heavy ticket electronics during this point of time. However, ensure that take your time to, if there have been older conversations that you need to revisit, by all means revisit and try and sort them. Try not to bring up fresher conversations or fresher debates and arguments specifically regarding your marriage. If you need to be revisiting something, then by all means do so. On the 11th, we have a full moon that is there in your house of self. And this is a very potent and a very emotional time for you, Librans, because there's going to be a sense of, you know, there's a sense of self-realization. You know, there's an acceptance, and it's an acceptance which could almost be slightly be heavy to wear. And also, I think there's going to be a sense of little bit of sadness around this, because I think for some of you, you're realizing that you know, as much as that you want to be really happy in life and you're willing to change, but you are questioning the sacrifice that is being asked of you during this time. So it's almost like a tug of war in the self, and this realization on how it is that you project yourself. Of course, for a lot of you, it will also be that this change is required, that you really need to be changing how you're dealing with or how you're presenting yourself to the world at large. Maybe you've got so used to being in a certain way, you know, that you've forgotten it, or you feel it's quite all right to be in a certain way. On the 16th, we have your ruling planet that goes direct, so great time to start. You can shop, you can buy lovely things, and you can go for that beautiful haircut. On the 20th, we have Sun that moves into your house of joint finances, sexuality and intimacy. And it's going to be bringing about opportunities to almost give a solution. So if there has been a battle between you and your partner, an emotional battle as to who brings what on the table and who deserves what, this is a time where you could almost sort of put things on the table and you could sort of have a solution for it. Maybe you are in a space where you are willing to give more, you know, you're going to be willing to share more, do your bit more. And also if there have been issues regarding intimacy, if you feel that, you know, that you're not sort of in the circle, so to speak, the circle of intimacy that is there between you and your partner, try and rebuild that, try and create that more. On the 22nd, we have Mars that is there in your house of spirituality and higher mind and consciousness. But we need to remember that Mercury is retrograde as well during this time. So it's good to reconnect with your dreams, your desires, and expand and want to travel and reconnect with people. But and there will also be a sense of be restlessness, but try and sort of not be too aggressive and try not to hunt it down. It's good to seek, it's good to even desire, but sort of getting obsessive about it is something that you just need to be a little careful about. On the 26th, we have a new moon that is there in your house of joint finances. So a lovely opportunity again to heal maybe things which have been sort of been, there's been a tug of war, an opportunity to give, an opportunity to be flexible, an opportunity to be open, Librans. It's been a pleasure speaking with you. I'll see you again soon. And thank you so much for watching.